Rachel, you and I have a guest waiting, and that is Mazie Hirono, Democrat of Hawaii, member, importantly, of Senate Judiciary. Senator, I know I could see you listening as I read a portion aloud of your colleague.
Did you see
Senator,
me rolling my eyes and muttering to myself?
I wasn't
too?
Going to characterize what I was seeing, but your reaction to Lamar Alexander and this parting statement tonight, as we reckon he's already home or close to it. He's a no vote, but backs up the case of the House managers in part, if not in full.
Did you get the impression from what he said that the House managers did prove that there was abuse of power, that he would vote to convict the president? I don't think so.
Yeah.
It didn't sound like that to me. So, you know, maybe he's going to split the baby. I do not know. But the fact of the matter is, even as to Article 2 on the obstruction of Congress, that they can put forth all kinds of claims to executive privilege and all that without really having to prove anything. And so it was blanket, it's comprehensive. In the law, we have this thing called, you know, good faith negotiations. If you're not negotiating in good faith, that's bad faith. And I would say that there's ample evidence to show that the president, who at the very outset said, I will fight every subpoena and I'm giving you nothing. By the way, throughout this whole process, he's called the process a witch hunt, a sham, whatever else. He had no intention of cooperating. So you bring out these lawyers to say, oh, well, he was actually asserting constitutional privileges. Don't make me laugh, okay? So let's get to the abuse of power. You have any questions about that?
Senator Hirono,
he did it.
Is it cold comfort to you that even as your colleague Lamar Alexander is saying he doesn't want to vote to hear witnesses, and perhaps with his decision here that forecloses that possibility, he is saying, by the way, I completely admit that he did it. He says it was inappropriate for the president to ask a foreign leader to investigate his political opponent when elected officials inappropriately interfere with such investigation. I mean, he's saying the question is not whether the president did it. He did it. I mean,
yes. And the question becomes, so, Rachel, this is the last response for these 2 days of question and answers that I got from the president's team. And that is, let's just assume he did it. So what? And I have been saying for a long time that's probably what they're going to end up with. You can say all these things, but so what? And the so what means that this president, who believes that he can do anything he wants under Article 2 of the Constitution, will continue to go forward. And I tell you, when the Trump team said, oh, well, you know, if you're going to impeach him and convict him for what he did, that means that this president is going to be facing impeachment at every turn. What they really are afraid of is that this president, unfettered, without a conviction, means that he's going to be doing a lot more stuff that will subject him to impeachment, because that's what this guy is. He believes he's king now.
If the president,
I think our country is in great danger.
Well, to that point, if the president has, in arguing his defense in this impeachment, has staked out new, totally unprecedented legal ground in which he and his legal advisors assert that he can do anything, he can condition the U.S. government's actions for anything that would help him for his reelection, as long as it's to try to help him get reelected, and he thinks that would be good for the country. I mean, what do you think this opens the gates to?
Which is the most bizarre kind of defense? And so there's Dershowitz. He hardly made sense at all throughout this whole thing. But, you know, what I get from Dershowitz, and he is part of their legal team, so I assume that the defense he was putting forward is something that they all subscribe to, even if they try to weasel out of parts of it. But, yes, it means that the president can ask for foreign interference in our elections, in spite of the fact that we have a law prohibiting that, but not to these guys. And then he can use money that the Congress has appropriated. He can illegally withhold that money and don't tell anybody either, because most of the time when we hold foreign aid, it's all out in the open, but this one was in secret. So now he can do it in secret. I mean, what other pot of money is he going to use to as a bribe? What other country is he going to bully? You know, this is a president who already we know he has very few constraints on his behavior, and there will be even fewer. He will be running around saying that he has been exonerated. No, he has been let off the hook by the Republicans, who are not going to vote for his conviction, but he is not going to be set free by the American people, I hope, who get that this was not a fair trial with no witnesses, no documents, total stonewalling by the president. And I don't care what kind of nice little legal constitutional defenses that they came up with, all, in my view, in bad faith.
Hey there, I'm Chris Hayes from MSNBC. Thanks for watching MSNBC on YouTube. If you want to keep up to date with the videos we're putting out, you can click subscribe just below me or click over on this list to see lots of other great videos.